hydrogen is one possible answer for our dependence on the fossil fuels that power our cars and buses. Even though vehicles that use hydrogen to spin their wheels have been on the market for years, the technology is still struggling to gain traction. That could change in the near future as the European Union and other countries have committed to expanding their use of green hydrogen. Yes, I specifically said green hydrogen because there are a couple ways of producing it, and not all of them move us toward the goal of cutting down on greenhouse gas emissions. Today, the most common hydrogen is known as gray hydrogen, and it's created from fossil fuels, like in a process called steam methane reforming. By combining ultra-hot steam with the methane in natural gas and a catalyst, the water vapor and methane react and produce hydrogen gas, carbon monoxide, and some carbon dioxide. A second step, called the water gas shift reaction, uses the carbon monoxide, steam, and another catalyst to extract more hydrogen gas, giving off CO2 as a waste product. Worldwide, about 95% of our hydrogen is gray. I think the problem here is pretty obvious. Sure, you can use hydrogen in a fuel cell-powered car and only give off water as a local waste product, but if the hydrogen was made through steam methane reforming, you're just shifting your carbon emissions from your tailpipe to a plant somewhere. There is a way to make the process more eco-friendly by capturing the CO2 and storing it or using it for other industrial applications, and hydrogen made this way is called blue hydrogen. Still, what we're after is the good stuff, the guilt-free stuff, the green stuff. Hydrogen is the most abundant element in the universe. It's found in this thing called water, which you may have heard of. Hydrogen can be pulled out of said water using electricity in a process called electrolysis. Using electricity from wind or solar power could vastly cut down on how much carbon dioxide the whole process creates. Hydrogen made this way is, you guessed it, green hydrogen. Of course, there's a catch. Green hydrogen is much more expensive to produce than gray or blue hydrogen. While a kilogram of green gas goes for about $6 today, the gray stuff is priced at just $1.60 per kilogram. Still, the European Union imagines natural gas as an important tool for getting to net zero carbon emissions by 2050. By improving electrolyzing machines and reducing the cost of renewable energy, green hydrogen could compete with its gray counterpart as soon as 2030. Then it could be applied in transportation, particularly for large vehicles like buses, trucks, and ships, where the drawbacks of current batteries make them less than ideal. But hydrogen has potential far beyond trucks or boats, and the EU has drawn up a roadmap of the ways green hydrogen could help them hit emissions targets. It could be used to decarbonize the gas grid and deliver heat and power around Europe. Adding it to the grid doesn't require huge upgrades, and energy producers could convert to use pure hydrogen. Essentially, hydrogen could be a way to produce energy in one place and then transport it for use or storage somewhere else, solving a big problem of renewables. Finally, hydrogen could be used in industrial processes to generate heat or replace coal-based blast furnaces in steel production. Right now, steel production is responsible for as much as 9% of global carbon emissions. It all sounds very tempting. Tempting enough that the EU proposed investing billions of dollars in green hydrogen. Separately, the UK is ramping up their own use of hydrogen, with buses and trains powered by the technology just entering service in a few trial cities. With reimagined transportation and a converted grid using hydrogen from clean sources, Europe could be a model for the world to follow if we're hoping to make fossil fuels a thing of the past. If you want to know more about the promise of hydrogen fuel, check out Josh's video here. So, do you think green hydrogen is the answer, or is there another green tech you think will revolutionize the world? Let us know in the comments, be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on Seeker.